Final step of the forehand is just your follow through. So from your contact point, extend out in the direction that you're hitting the tennis ball, and then bring your arm across your body in a smooth and relaxed motion. But the key point you got to keep in mind is once you've extended out and now you're bringing your arm across your body, pretend you have a watch on and you're turning your hand over as you bring your arm across your body like you're trying to check the time. From his contact point, Frank extends out in the direction that he's hitting the tennis ball. And then once he's extended out, he turns his hand over like he has a watch on and he's trying to check the time. And then from this position, he brings his arm across his body in a smooth and relaxed motion to complete his follow through. This is Andy Roddick having just made contact with the tennis ball, and he's extending out in the direction that he's hitting. And I'm actually standing on the tennis ball, it's right behind me. But as he extends out, he starts to turn his wrist over. You can see that here, his wrist has just started to turn over like he has a watch on, and he's trying to check the time. And if we take a look at a different shot, this is him a little bit later in his follow through. The wrist is a little bit more turned over, and the arm and the racket have started to come across his body. And he'll continue to bring the racket and his arm across his body until the completion of his follow through, which looks like this. The racket is wrapped around his shoulder, and his wrist is clearly turned over. It's turned all the way over. Now, Andy doesn't always follow through like this. Sometimes he follows through more around his body, and that's what this looks like. And I'm not going to get into the specifics of why he might follow through here versus around his shoulder, but the key element of the follow through is that you will always extend out in the direction that you're hitting, and you'll always turn your wrist over.